students of class 8. As you know that we have completed many chapters, explanation of many chapters, it means we are just ending of your textbook. So we have completed many chapters from your Honeydew textbook. Here I am also going to start new poem from your Honeydew textbook, poem number 8. The title of this poem is On the Grasshopper and the Cricket. Right, these beautiful birds, it's a grasshopper. Have you seen that grasshopper means jo hum green color ka usko hum TDU aise tiriya bolte hai, right? Green color ka jo hota hai usko bolte hai. Especially we are showing that the birds, especially that insects, insect in the monsoon season, right? So here this grasshopper also and the cricket is also one kind of small insect. So here the poet John Keats, the poet of this poem is John Keats. That on the grasshopper and the cricket, this poem written by John Keats, one of the romantic is poet. So he has just written this poem and he was just using this idea because the poet was finding the beauty of nature that time, right? During this different, what we people are just thinking that in a winter season we are getting the nature, beauty of the nature. But here the poet was thinking that I can see the beauty of nature in all the season, and that's why he was written this poem, depends on the nature, right? Beauty of the nature. And he hoped that. So main theme of this poem is the beauty of nature. And also we can say hope. Hope, right? What we have to hope from this, what we have to learn from this poem. So here we see, first of all, it's a mind made things of this poem. It means that introduction of this poem, what the poet had described and what is the background of this poem, how he inspired to write this poem. So we'll see here, students. So first of all, I would like to tell you that on the grasshopper and the cricket, this poem written by John Keats in December 1816. So in this year, this poem already written by the John Keats. So it is written in December 1816, right? It's a patriarchal sonnet containing an octave and a sustain. As you know that I have discussed this thing, sonnet means it's a song, right? You can say, and this is also a sonnet. Which sonnet is that? It's a patriarchal sonnet. This, remember this, means this sonnet just confirmed by the William Wordsworth. He is the founder of the sonnet. As we know that William Wordsworth has given the types of the sonnets, it's also one of the sonnet, that is the patriarchal sonnet, right? Patriarchal sonnet, which is divided into two parts, that is the octave and sustain, right? So here we can say that student, octave means 8 lines and sustain means 6 lines. So here in this poem also we have to see that it's a patriarchal sonnet divided into two para, two stanza. We can see in your, you can see in your textbook also, this poem divided into two para. First para, it is about the grasshopper and it is the octave, and second is the sustain, it is about the cricket, right? What these two insects symbolize, that we'll see during the explanation. So further that, I would like to tell you about the writer, poet of this poem. So it is the octave and sustain. Remember this poem. Now we'll see about the poet. Students, here John Keats, it is about the John Keats. So here we will see these things here about the poet John Keats, who was born on 31st October 1795 and died on 23rd February 1821. Again I am repeating this, listen this. John Keats was born on 31st October 1795 and died on 23rd February 1821. He is an English romantic poet. As we know that, right, there are different ages in English literature. So first it was about the, we can say the Shakespearean, or sorry, Shakespearean age, right? First age. Second one is that Jacobean age. Like that only we have total 7 ages, and last age was that only. Last period it was, that is the Roman decades. Now in this time we can say that we are living in modern age, right? So here this was the last age, Romantic age, and Romantic poetess, it means here 117 to 18 decade, this poet had just given his contribution in English literature. So John Keats just is English Romantic poet, you can see. He died at a very young age due to tuberculosis, right? So here, tuberculosis, right? So here, students, we can say this person is just very, in a young age, he died because of this tuberculosis, right? So this disease, because of this disease, he died over there. His famous works are Ode to Nightingale. It's also a very beautiful poem. Remember this. You can read, you can find it on Google. Ode to Nightingale, also really very beautiful poem written in the beauty of the nature. Sleep and Poetry, on first looking into Chapman's home. So these books are the notable works of the John Keats. So here we have talked about the poet student. So here we have completed the poem background in which year it written. It written in 1816, right? So December 1816 we have completed about the poet. Now we'll see the central idea of the poem. So students, here it is. Before that, I would like to tell you this poem is the Petrarchan sonnet. So I said that here two stanzas given. First stanza is about the octave and second is about the sestet. So in the first stanza, it is the we can say stanza, it is the separated into two parts. Here it is given. The poem is not separated into stanza. It is separated into two parts, that is the octave and sestet. The first part of the poem, the octave celebrates the earth in all its forms. It says that the poetry of the earth is never dead. The earth provided poetry in the form of the songs of the birds or the calls of the beasts. However, when the summer sun is too hot and strong, the birds find it difficult to keep up their routine. They find shelter from the scorching heat in trees that provide an ample shade and hence are cooling. So here it's the first stanza there. Whenever we are just getting their birds also have tried the feelings and sensation of the different season. So here also the poet was just celebrating that the earth has never dead. Earth always ready to give us the beauty, the satisfaction. Only they are just giving us the joyful atmosphere. So here he said different birds also has affected by different season. Here also we are talking about the different birds. Two birds, that is the grasshopper and the second one is the cricket. They are also affected, but they are also had never left and removed their beauty, how they are enjoying. Right, so it is about the octave. Still it is continuous, students, here. But the grasshopper doesn't cease its song. Its voice runs throughout the freshly mown meadows untiringly. Even in the Saturday summer days, he never stops his chants. And grasshopper does not feel faint under the sun. For him, even the summer is a time for joy. Hence, when he has had his fill of fun, he finds comfort under some leaves or long grass stalk. So here it is about the experience of the grasshopper in summer season. So students, we can say that the poet was poet John Keats, symbolizing what grasshopper is. We can say he also just happy specially on all summer, right? So here we can see, students, this grasshopper is just symbolizing which season? Summer season. And we can say that we'll see in the second paragraph, that is the octave, what he said. The sestet begins with the earlier declaration that the poetry of the earth is forever. It is named on the drowsy evening by the fire. And that is the cricket. The poet tells us that during the winters, instead of growing white of the cold, the cricket finds a corner in some kitchen near a stove and cries out its song. Its song, warmth coming from the stove mingles with the warm tones of the cricket who tries to keep one entertained. So in the second stanza, means in the second part, in the first state, we can say that students here is about the cricket's nature, right? How he just expressed and felt in this winter season, right? So it's a cold winter over there, and after that he was just continued his singing, right? It means he had not removed, he had not left that his skill, but he continued that things here. That's why the poet was just expressing this in these two parts, that is the sustain and second is the octave, right? In the octave he was just talking about the grasshopper, and grasshopper was symbolizing with the hot summer. In the second part it is about the sustain, and he talked about the cricket. Cricket is symbolizes with the cold winter, right? So how these two insects were enjoying themselves in the different season. Now we'll see the central idea of the book. So central idea of the book is the tendency of city of the grasshopper and the cricket to provide us the entertainment and joy us through their respective songs. Their songs are the poetry of the earth, poetry that never ceases to be even during extreme circumstances. So this is the central idea of this poem. Now students will read the poem, so listen me carefully how to read this poem. See students, here it's the first part. It is the octave. See, 8 lines, 4 and 4. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is, we can say it is octave, right? So students, this is the first part. The poetry of earth is never dim, when all the birds are faint with the hot sun, and hide in cooling trees, a voice will run from heads to heads about the new moon meat. That is the grasshoppers, he takes the lead in summer luxury he has never done, with his delights, for when tired out with fun, he rests at ease beneath some decent tree. So students, here first stanza, a first part, it is about the octave. Now we see in the second, it's a sustain, right? Sustain is this only because it has 6 lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is the sustain. So students, here the poetry of earth is seizing neighbor on the alone winter evening, when the frost has brought a silence from the stove their shrills. The cricket song in warmth increasing ever, and seems to one in rosiness half lost, and the grasshoppers among some grassy hills. So here students, we have completed the reading of this poem. As we know that the main idea, or we can say the setting of this poem, is this only: the mood of the poem is a joyous. The poem seeks to celebrate the calls of the grasshopper and the cricket, in short the voice of nature herself. The setting is almost luxurious, as in it celebrates all phase of nature. So students, we can imagine that during this, right, we are on the near of the nature, and that time what happened, this type of birds, grasshopper and cricket, they are just singing nearby we people. So how we felt? Absolutely, it's a luxurious atmosphere around we people, right? So students, we can say that this poem is really the very clear abstracts, and we can say perceptions given to we people, it, that it's a perspective poem based on the theme, that is the nature, it's a beauty. So here students, we can see that John Keats was writing this poem by giving us the idea about nature and how we have to live during the difficult time, how to learn from that particular difficult time. That's the message and that's the moral of this poem. So John Keats has given us beautiful poem that is the On the Grasshopper and the Cricket. So students, here we are just stopping this poem because we have to complete the this poem in the next session. It means here in the next video you people will see the explanation of this poem. So it is just the introduction of the poem number 8 from your Honeydew textbook, On the Grasshopper and the Cricket. So students, thank you and have a great day.